A common use for loops is in programs that simulate some activity, such as customers in a supermarket, cars on a road, particles in a physical system. And in such simulations, you want to have a degree of randomness just to model how the real world works. For example, some random time might elapse until the next customer arrives, or the customer might buy a random number of articles. So let me show you how to generate random numbers in Java. You construct an object of the random class, and then you can ask it to give you another integer. You have to give it an upper limit, and you get an integer between 0 and n minus 1. You can also generate a random floating point number, and then you always get a number that's at least 0 but less than 1. Let me show you the random number generator in BlueJ. Let's make an object by going to the Tools menu, Use Library class, and here in the class field, we type in java.util.random and hit the Enter key. Select this constructor, and here we have a random number generator. Let's ask it for next double, and we get 0.05 and change. That looks pretty random. Next time when we ask it, we get a different random number, 0.19 and so on. For integers, we'll pick this method over here. We asked for an upper bound, and now I'll get a number that's between 0 and 999. In this case, I get 781. When I do it again, I get a different number. Of course, every once in a while, I might get the same number twice. It's random. Now I'll let you play with this. We want to simulate a die so that we get random numbers between 1 and 6. Or actually, we might as well model a die with an arbitrary number of sides. And your job is to implement the cast method so that every time that it's called, it returns a different number between 1 and the number of sides of the die. There's just a catch. You're going to have to call the nextInt method, which naturally gives you numbers between 0 and n minus 1. You want numbers from 1 to n, and I leave it to you to figure out how to change one to the other. As a construction parameter, for debugging, it's handy to give the random number generator what's called a seed, and as long as you seed a generator with a particular value, then it gives always the same stream of seemingly random numbers. Here we're using a fixed seed so that you and I get the same answers. In practical applications, people do all sorts of things for seeding, such as using the time of day, or when true randomness is desired, they actually have a white noise generator attached to their computer and sample it. So go ahead and implement the cast method.